So how did you get from beginning to the end in the song in terms of the beat, the music, the producer?
Okay. See, so Hash Beats produced that one too. So I called him up. I'm like, look, man, I'm about to do, you know, do the song with Kato. Yuck, man, fuck with Yuck Mouth on that. He's like, all right, okay, I'm gonna send you this. And then when he sent it to me, I'm like, damn, man, what are we gonna talk about? So then I'm like, okay, well, since he fuck with Yuck Mouth, let's take, it's a sample from E-40 on here, California Bears, not no California Raisin. My hood didn't breed no chimpanzee, my hood, that's from E-40. So I'm like, well, since he, you know what I mean, they Bay Area, they connect with, I'm like, put that on the, as the hook, and then we just fill in the blanks. As soon as I called Kato up and sent him the track, he was on it. He came right here immediately and then knocked that shit out. And I'm like, damn, he gonna need to do a video for this shit. We did a video and voila, it's out in the universe.
Yeah, I saw that. And the video got some really nice visuals. Who helped you with the shooting that?
A youngster that by the name of Lux360 Lux, a little Asian cat. He fucked with a lot of the young talent. You know, he's a youngster himself, but he does a lot of videos with the young talent on here. He pretty popular too.
Now, you shot that video on like a rooftop near downtown LA.
Yeah, you know it's a trip? That day when we shot that video, when MC8 from Contest Most Wanted was there, that's a studio where we shot that. But the guys, it was a group called The Alcoholics. And a guy named Tony Hasbin, J-Roe from The Alcoholics, DJ Master C, they fuck with Battle Cat and all them. That's all in that building. It's a gang of different artists that be in that building. You know what I mean? Then that day, I don't know why he didn't put the footage on there, but I'm like, hey, man, when you, he for Contest Most Wanted. I'm like, man, could you get in the video? He like, look, he's like, all right, man. He got it. Everybody be at that building. It was right there in downtown.
And what made you just do it on the roof of that building?
I was like, well, fuck it, you know what I mean? And then I was really trying to get some scenes of us in the studio with The Alcoholics too, you know what I mean? With J-Roe, Master C and them, you know what I mean? So I was like, well, fuck it, man, let's just do it here. Since we, you know what I mean? We haven't done it like this yet. It was a couple of people that kind of like, oh, man, you did it during the fire. Because I guess they could tell the way the sky was looking that there was the fires going on. Oh, and that was just a good look. And then he had that drone, and then launching it from the rooftop, you get the good L.A. background and all that. You know. And then there was a couple of people that showed up from a crew called West Coast Creations. I've been dealing with them, too. And they're a label as well. And some of them came and showed up and showed support for the video as well. I'm fucking with them, too.
What was Kato's reaction?
He liked it. He's like, ah, you know, he's a real hyper. He liked it. Cause he was, before we filmed it, he's like, man, this shit gotta look like, you know, cause you know, he know a lot of people. Kato knew a lot of people. So he liked it. And when I got a stamp of approval, I'm like, okay, it's a good job, man. Ape Shit by Mr. CR featuring Katofornia. It came out really great.
And you guys were also standing in front of that Nipsey Hussle mural.
Yeah, just trying to pay our homage. We're supposed to do just paying homage. It was supposed to be like a moment of silence type of thing, how we was trying to make it look.
Any final thoughts before we wrap this up?
Yeah, man, I would just like to say, man, you know, every gang is different and all that, but just the one I chose to be from, I found out, no, that shit was not worth it. All that shit was a waste of time, bro. It's just, I seen Nipsey said in the interview, he said, when you traveling on your road to get where you need to be, you got the beginning and you got the end and everything in between don't matter. So, you know what I mean? So that's, I'm like, that's what helped me. I'm like, you know what, everything in between all that bullshit, it don't matter. But all I'll just say, just focus on whatever it is you trying to do with your life, man. Just focus on that shit, man, and make that shit happen.
So you're really soured about this situation.
Hell yeah, I'm telling you, I just now let that shit go. I mean, as far as talk myself out of going over there and do so, because I don't want to throw my life away. You know what I mean? It ain't really worth it. And then my boy told me straight up, if you didn't really give a fuck about it, then why are you still talking about it? Just let that shit go. I'm like, you know what? You're right. As long as I don't see none of them dudes, I ain't tripping.
Do you still have a love for the neighborhood?
Nope.
None of that.
Fuck them niggas.
Because sometimes people still have a love for the neighborhood.
I ain't got none love for none of that shit. Fuck all that shit. That was a big waste of my time. I fucked my life up behind that shit for the niggas to do me like that. Fuck that shit.
And before we close out,
it's not worth it.
How much time did you spend in prison over this stuff?
Man, I've been going to jail all my life behind that, trying to prove I was not the bitch ass nigga y'all thought I was type of shit. You know, I was always the guy getting picked on, and I turned into the dude that people were scared of after a while. They said when that shit happened to me, they said, hey, I was driving a Jeep at the time. They said every time a Jeep would drive down the street, niggas would start running. I'm like, nigga, I ain't. I'm just saying, but I mean, ain't nothing to brag about, but I'm just saying, that's, yeah.
But you've been to prison a few times.
Yeah.
And behind this stuff.
Behind this bullshit. And then this the trip part about it. And I'm like, we beefing with these dudes, and some of you dudes is going to jail for being friends with these dudes. When I'm in jail fucking off my visits. You can't, it's all fake, bro. Favoritism and fake shit. All that shit is fake. And at the end of the day, it's not worth it. It's just a bunch of senseless bullshit that's about nothing, bro. What was it all worth? Nothing. It's the sad part about it is you got people doing life in jail behind killing somebody from a gang that they didn't get along with back then. Now they all cool now. What was the whole point in doing it?
Yeah, but if you go to a level 3 or level 4, you got to be side by side with your enemy because of the racial politics. Right?
Yeah, but then at the same time though too, you know it's when you go to jail, it's blacks against everybody else, including your own kind.
Thanks for watching StreetTV.net. If you're not subscribed, please hit that button below and click the bell to receive alerts and notifications. Feel free to comment below so you can give us your feedback, and be sure to watch the two related episodes to the right. If you want to support this platform or follow us on social media, visit the links in the description, and thanks for watching StreetTV.net.